Hello YouTube, this is a video demonstration and explanation of the 4-bit computer that I have designed and built over the last few months. It uses 51 integrated circuits, all in the 74LS series, except for the two 5514 memory chips, and all performing relatively simple tasks. The architecture of the machine is similar to that of the computer described at cpuville.com. This website is really great if you are a hobbyist interested in how basic computers work at the electronic or logic gate level. The machine has a 4-bit wide address bus, allowing it to access a whole 16 bytes of RAM. Obviously, this is not much to work with, but this computer certainly wasn't designed for running long programs or practicality in general. Its data bus is 8 bits wide, allowing the computer to load the 4-bit instruction or opcode and the 4-bit operand at the same time. However, because the accumulator is only 4 bits wide, half of the memory byte is wasted when the accumulator is stored to a memory location. Anyway, this computer is a finite state machine, which means it can only be in a certain number of states, in this case, 9. States are as follows. State 0 is the instruction fetch slash increment program counter state. Program counter in this computer is a register, which is routed through the ALU, or arithmetic logic unit, every state 0, where a 1 is added to it. State 1, instruction interpret. This state is kind of unnecessary. It's where the computer decides which state to branch off to based on the opcode and the zero flag, which is derived directly from the accumulator. There's no flip-flop, it's just some OR gates. State 2, transfer operand to data register. This computer, like the CPU-ville design, has a data register to store immediate data from the instruction register to be processed by the arithmetic logic unit. State 3, arithmetic slash logic. The accumulator and data register are routed through the ALU, and the result is stored in the accumulator. State 4, load accumulator from memory. The low 4 bits, or nibble, of an immediate memory location are stored in the accumulator. State 5, load accumulator with an immediate value. That's pretty self-explanatory. State 6 and 7 are store accumulator to memory. This takes two states in this case, and therefore two clock cycles to write the memory. I did this because it was easiest to have the memory write signal go low in the middle of the one cycle and high in the middle of the next, than to pack it into one cycle. Finally, state 8, which is jump to an immediate address. This moves the address in the instruction register into the program counter. All of these states control various control lines within the computer, such as register write and multiplexer select lines. All of this is hardwired in logic chips rather than stored in a ROM chip. The board here, next state logic, is this whole breadboard section, as well as the first two chips on this breadboard section. Now, a part of the computer that actually processes the data is the arithmetic logic unit, located here. This whole board, as well as the two chips there, make up the arithmetic logic unit and associated multiplexers. In this case, the arithmetic logic unit can add and perform logical operations AND, OR, and NOT, all on 4-bit numbers, which means you have a range from 0 to 15 for both the input numbers and, of course, the output of the ALU. One thing I should have incorporated was an exclusive OR, because it would have been able to perform the same function as a NOT gate, and more as well. There's no carry flip-flop, because I was too lazy to do that. The carry out of the full adder is completely ignored. However, there is an add with carry set instruction in case you want to subtract or something crazy like that. Anyways, enough of that. Let's take a look at the actual hardware and operation. So, we'll start with the clock. Currently, the only clock in place is a single stepping clock, which, yeah, it's most useful when debugging. It is stepped by moving this yellow wire in between the two resistor nodes. Like so. Kind of awkward, but I didn't have enough room for a nice switch. Here we have the mode selection wire. It selects program mode, which is with the wire like this. Reset mode, which is with the wire free floating. And run mode, which is with the wire connected to pin 2 of this decoder chip. Whilst in programming mode, the memory address is entered by these wires, like so. And the data with these wires, also like so. After the data and the address have been set, the memory is written by pulling out this wire temporarily. All operation is monitored using these LEDs. Just remember, the most significant bit in each set of LEDs is towards the power terminals here, rather than the bottom. Yes, this way is the most significant bit. For power, a LM323K voltage regulator is used. Obviously, for a circuit built with TTL components, the supply voltage is 5 volts DC, of course. This computer draws about 1 amp when running and 600 milliamps when idle. This regulator can support up to 3 amps. So, let's run something, shall we? I have prepared a small program that will add 7 plus 8 and the result with 1010 in binary, or that result with 0101 in binary, and then effectively subtract 1 from the result. 1 is in the number 1. And store that result, which should be 14 or 1110 in binary, in memory location 15 or 1111 in binary, which is the last memory location. It should be mentioned that the instruction format is the opcode in the low nibble and the operand in the high nibble. Before I do run this program, I should point out which LEDs are which. These LEDs here are the data bus. This grouping of 4 is the accumulator. This grouping of 4 is the data register. This grouping of 8 is the instruction register. This 4 is the state register. This grouping of 4 is the address bus, and this grouping of 4 is the program counter. Now, remember, most significant bit is this way. So this would be the most significant bit here, most significant bit here, most significant bit here, most significant bit, etc. Alright, here we go. Alright, and now when we look memory location 1111 in programming mode, we should see our answer. And indeed we do. Ignoring the four most significant bits, the answer is 1110, or 14, which is exactly what we predicted it would be.